plains and forests, the water flows down towards the Baltic Sea bay known as Broviken. People exploit its power and all that the fresh water brings with it. The presence of salmon and the power of the water currents leads to fishing villages being created and mills being built. Fishermen and millers are the first inhabitants of an area that gradually develops into the medieval town of Norrköping. In 1604, the Parliament is assembled in Norrköping. There, Johan III's 15-year-old son, Johan, renounces all claims to the throne in favor of his uncle Karl. In return, he is crowned Duke of Östergötland. The Duke promised to be loyal and faithful to my peasants, to govern in council, to respect the privileges of my subjects, and not to levy any new tax upon them. The latter was a promise he didn't keep for very long. The kingdom is at war with Poland and Russia, and there is a great need for weapons and armor. In 1609, an armory is founded at Holmen in the river, where armorsmiths such as Pierre Georges, Anthony Coppens, and Marcus Thompsons, and gunsmiths such as Gregorius Retz and Per Olofsson Rushmead work. The Duke donates land to encourage foreign labor, artisans and merchants to immigrate to the area. He offers to exempt them from custom duties and wants them to build stone houses in Saltingen. It is here that he has his own residence, the Johannesburg Fortification built. At this time, Norrköping is Sweden's second largest town, and the Duke makes it his capital. He gives Norrköping sole rights as an export harbor for goods produced in the inland towns, including the cannons from the gun factory in Finspång. At Holmen, the business expands with the help of immigrant entrepreneurs. Willem de Besch, who successfully operated the Sodomaland mills for Duke Karl, contacts his partner in Amsterdam, Louis de Geer, already a major trader in weapons and gunpowder, and they develop a brasswork with a total of 18 furnaces. It was to become the country's largest and remain the dominant industry for Holmen for almost 200 years, with exports to Germany, the Netherlands and France, among other countries. Abraham and Isaac Emmerich and Isaac's son Carl found a paper mill on Lex Holmen. Here, papermaker Caspar Vedermann is responsible for using rags to produce writing and confectionery paper, royal paper, and many other paper products. That's how an industrial landscape was formed along the River Strömmen in Norrköping. Holmen's unbroken and successful history of industrious work and changing destiny has so far lasted 400 years.